a very humbling and amazing experience to hear the different climate change work that's happening all around the world. One thing is clear, everyone has said in every panel that I've listened to, in every corner of the halls, that the science is real and there's no more debating. We've got work to get to. And what experiences can we share? What are those challenges? What are those successes? Let's work together and talk about how we're going to accomplish keeping the 1.5 degrees Celsius alive mission.
I grew up in a small town, and I'm always reminded of my eighth grade teacher who kept above our blackboard in our classroom a sign that said, think globally and act locally. And as you know, two directors of a board that is responsible for adopting and regulating emission standards across the 9-county region of the Bay Area, that sometimes feels really large to us. But when you come here, you realize just how small but important local advocacy and local regulation and rulemaking and innovation is to solving these global problems.
When the federal government finally moves to put a price on carbon, then we'll have to look at the California program and its future in that light and see how they mesh together. But, you know, in several parts of the world, they have both a cap and invest or cap and trade program and a carbon tax. And there's no reason why you can't do both.
Indigenous people is such a broad term, and I feel like it gets thrown out a lot. But really, it's just the people of the land, the stewards of the land. And I've met so many people from all over the world. And it really just goes to show, like, Indigenous sovereignty is going to heal us. How do you even talk about or have a conversation about healing the lands without consulting the stewards of the land first?
And I've had a number of countries tell us that they are moving towards carbon pricing based on the California model. They're moving towards air quality and emissions and vehicle standards based on Governor Newsom's executive action.